I know I'm spending a lot of time on this, but it's important. This is permanent. At least it should be. It disappears into the body of Sabine. Let's see. 45, 47, 39, 49, 34, 41, 19, 10. Okay. Skills 43, 20, 90, 0, 61, 86, 46, 106, 106. Oh, wait. It gives spell learning points. She has now 29 spell learning points instead of 4. 16 and then 15. That's all it did. It increased her spell learning points, which is good because she needs that. She had 4, so I'm happy with her having that. I mean, I could use some too, but I did just do a lot of training. Actually, no, I'm talking about spell learning points, not training points, my bad. Well, they both have 29 now. And I have 26, so that evens us out. I'm happy with that. So there's only one door, apparently, the one we came through. I am gonna check these two walls for secrets. Make sure that these are actually walls and not something that we can walk through. Okay. You look good. Alright, so now did we check the far wall? Check it. I think we did. Just gonna check it. Okay. Where am I? Oh, I went through. Okay, so now we have this door. And we have another. Okay, so there's that there, but there's a hallway or something here. Oh. Appears to be a dead end. Takes so long to turn when you're right up against the seal, the wall. The textures. And it's funny. I guess that's lighting up the room because our torch just went out. Yet we can still see. So we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to save, because there's a very good chance they're going to be loading up again. I'll see any differences to Sabine now. A shining necklace hovers in a ball of light before you. Should Sabine reach for the necklace? Instant death. As Sabine touches the necklace, there's a sudden loud explosion and lightning flashes around the group. Then, with a thunderous roar, a blue light gate opens before you, through which you can see into a different world. In a room behind the gate, you can see two shadowy figures. Check out that artwork. Okay, we've opened a portal to a different world. And two shadowy figures, I guess, which now we're going to fight? Suddenly, one of the figures is hit by a flash of light and catapulted towards you through the gate. With an enormous thundering sound, the gate closes and all lights go out. For a moment, it is deathly still, then you hear angry growling. Are you growling? Okay, the light's gone. Keep my eye on you. Does she have a necklace now? No. I don't suppose I took it. Okay, so we reach for the necklace, but it opened a portal. Before you stands a strange being, half human and half cat. He looks at you with eyes glittering with rage. Half human and half cat. We've got a Khajiit here. And a very angry one. I poke the Khajiit. Poke. I talk. Valdyn. Felinic male. Felinic? Felinic male? 22 ranger 8. 8 level ranger. Grr, where have I landed? Is it your fault? I was just about to release my petrified girlfriend from a curse, but just as I wanted to hang the amulet around her neck, I was hit by an enormous flash of lightning. Huh. Well, somehow the amulet was seen in our world. And then I grabbed it, and that's how the lightning happened, I guess. Amulet. Valdyn lifts up high the necklace which you saw earlier in the sphere of light. Oh, so he has it. Then he says, I found it during my adventure. I hoped I could use it to remove the curse from my girlfriend. What curse? I killed a powerful magician a few days ago. He stole a valuable jewel, the Lionheart, and turned my lady friend to stone. You too can experience the adventures of Valdyn. Buy Lionheart for your Amiga today. Okay, yeah, that is another game, actually, that this development group worked on. Lionheart, which I heard is a very good, like, platformer type game. So I wonder if that's the events of the game. You kill a magician at the end. Or you kill a magician at the beginning. I guess it probably starts with him stealing the jewel. And then Valdyn going to retrieve it. And then killing him near the end. Something to that effect. I don't play platformers, so... I wonder if there's anything else you might have to say about... He's not gonna know anything about this world. He doesn't come here. I mean, he's not from here. Hello. You don't know anything special about hello. Have you had a good journey? You're a madman. What about the mage? No. Girlfriend? No. He's forgotten all about her, apparently. The curse. A jewel. Magician. Ah, that's a typo. My universal translator failed me at that moment. Jewel. Okay, and then he also said not mage, but magician. No, let's see if I can squeeze any more text out of him, of this guy. He might join our group, and then we fall. Do you have any problems? This here is Sabine. Sphere of opening, I don't suppose no. Anything about this tower? No. A thing. No. Do you know a tomcat? No. Alright, do you want to join our group? Rawr, you want me to join you? Well, why not? Perhaps you will find a way for me to return. Excellent. Valdymort. His name is Valdyn. Ready to talk at all times, but about not much. So now we're getting dark. Well, that was certainly interesting. I was suspecting, or I was expecting. No charges left, okay. Dump it. This here. So micromanaging here. Okay. So you have three lanterns left. I think they're all full. Well, they were. Excellent, my friends. It is nice to see you again. Have you found a way for me to return home? No. Alright, let's check out his stats and such. Valdyn's Amulet. Okay. It gives him plus 35 luck, plus 25 use magic, and has a stone to flesh. Oh, so he was about to use that amulet on her to change his girlfriend from turn to stone. Back into flesh. Alright. All I have to do is get him back there. He's got the tool he needs. Valdyn's leather. Just the fact that it has his name on it gives him shield plus 10. Valdyn's sword. Plus 20 damage. Valdyn's shoes. Plus 5. Alright, and his stats are as such. 65 strength out of 70. 38 intelligence. 79 dexterity, 88 out of 80 speed, 42 stamina, 40 charisma, 26 luck, and 5 avoid magic, I think AM is for. And then attack 58, parry 57, swim 38, critical 1% out of 5, find traps Okay, he's got some roguish skills here. 22 find traps, 36 disarm traps, 5% lockpicking. Not really useful, we have Selena for that stuff. 82 search, 42 read magic, 41 use magic. Sweet. And he has 96 life points, 48 SP, well, power points, or spell points, rather. Spell learning points, 16, 96 training points. I'm not sure if I'm going to be keeping him. I mean, I'll keep him until we find someone else. But out of all of us, he's the one I would drop. But I do want to see if we can fulfill his quest. If we told him to leave the group, I wonder if he'd just come back to this tower. He probably would. Okay, so his attack is 20, his defense is 15. He comes with some golden rations. And then, okay, for spells he has Monster Knowledge and Show Monster LP. That's pretty cool. So we can learn knowledge about these things. And, yeah, see their hit points or life points. So I'm just going to search at this point for hidden. I think I already did, but I'm going to search it again. I'm going to be thorough here. It looked like I was about to find something on that wall, didn't it? Didn't I? I thought I saw something at the end there. No? Mm. Alright, just making sure. And I'm pretty well convinced at this point that there's no secret hidden walls here. Alright, so we go back through here, make a left, and that brings us to the stairs. Closer to Luminor, I'm supposing. So let's put me back. So he is taller than Citrine. Citrine and Agile are the same height. Selena's smaller. Nelvin's taller. Sabine is also the same height. Valdyn's a little bit taller, but not as tall as Nelvin. Nelvin, I guess, clips through the ceiling, if you could see him, you know, not in first person. Alright, saving. I guess we're safe to assume we're up to LP 66. So that is awesome. We have found two more people. And, yeah, some of you might be thinking, well, a bug is going to come up, or a bug would have happened. But this is a patched version that apparently takes the bug out. When you pick up either Sabine and or Valdyn, you have to use a jump spell to get out of or into the room. That was taken out. So, very grateful to whoever did that. So I am a lot better at use magic now. I'm a little bit better. I'm 50. I wish my read magic was 0. I mean, I wish my read magic was 50 and my use magic was 100. I would gladly swap those. I want to give her... I want to see if I can get these protections on. Because Luminor lies at the top of this tower. I'm not sure how many floors there are. I mean, I'm on three now. And by not sure, I'm meaning I have no idea. So... Oh, no, no, no. I keep clicking that instead of... I wonder if that's where it used to be in Ambermoon. Because I just naturally go to that area. I mean, some buttons were changed around. I don't want them to use food needlessly. I don't know if she can carry all this. We'll see. See, I keep going there. She can't carry it all, so I'm just gonna... And then we're gonna wait around for 8 hours so we can sleep again. I don't know why they did this. I'm sorry if I'm being repetitive. It's just, it was hard enough to rest and get everything back. You know, I was hoping Ambermoon might have a rest until healed option, but no. Instead, you can't even rest twice in a row without it telling you you don't need to, but you do because you want to get your points back. So I beg to differ, we do need to. So I am going to... let's see if we can cast these spells. Magical shield. Worked the first time. Good to see. Magical weapon. Failed. Failed. And it worked. Excellent. So we will now save. Because we are ready for bear here. We have our healer. I don't want to quit. Okay, level 4, Luminor's Tower. Oh! I saw that at the last second. Suddenly, huge iron bars shoot out of the ground before you and inflict painful injuries. Okay, Citrine dies. Well. What? You're gonna have me select a leader over and over again? They're all gonna die. How does that work? Only the leader dies? This is why we save all the time. Okay, so there's gonna be a spot for disarming that, most probably. Oh, there's a door there as well. There's random fires around. Can we safely pass through? As you come into contact with the wandering flame, it explodes and injures you. All right, that's not the way through. Can I disarm these? Guessing if we could. It would be this way. And that just goes down. So maybe we have to wander through the flames. Turn it off in this room. See if we have a secret along this wall. Oh! I didn't even see a flame there. Edgel survives it. I just want to see. As you come close to the lava, it shoots up like a geyser and burns you severely. There's got to be a way through, right? Oh, they are wandering around. Well, it's kind of hard to navigate this in first person. Do they move when we move? I don't know. It moved over there. This one's right in front of us now. Does that have a word on it? It looked like this one just ran right up to us. Yeah. Doesn't have a word on it. Ugh. Edgel is lucky and survived the trap. Okay, that must be the luck stat at work. He survives the trap again. Well, he's not good at traps. We hear a strange sound. Well, this is certainly a conundrum. I don't know how to get past this. Other than just trial and error. Let's go over here. There's one in front of us. There's one over there and over there. They're pretty close to us. It's coming over to us. That one moved. Okay, lava, okay. Is there a way to extinguish these flames? I mean, we don't. Maybe if we get past that trap. there'll be something we can use to go back and extinguish those, but I don't... Looking on the wall. That's not a button, is it? I don't think we can step forward anymore. Nope. I keep thinking, what if we have to disarm it in here? We can't even go this way because the lava hurts us. That's unacceptable to have everyone dead anyway. Even if we could open that. I mean, we're probably supposed to avoid them and go this way. We did get through there. Okay, so if we can just get past them. Then Selena can open that, and then. I don't know what's in there. Obviously. We did make it past them. Oh, that's a lava. Hold on 1 second, guys. Okay. I don't think I can get past, like, through these. Ugh. No, we need to be... on this side. Ugh. So if we go straight forward, we hit that. I think we want to stay on this side, if at all possible. Hopefully the fires don't rush up. Because there is one right there. If we hug the wall... No. Well, we escaped the trap, right? So... Can we just... Where's this thing? Okay. Okay, she discovers a trap. She disarms the trap. Unable to pick the lock. If we choose this...